In this video, we are discussing about the all silver teacups. It is easy to understand to find the value of sine 420 degrees, tan 135 degrees and cos 240 degrees means above the 90 degrees, how to find the trigonometric ratios in this chapter. Now, we are discussing about first of all, in on x-axis and y-axis, you draw children and you identify quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3 and quadrant 4. In quadrant 1, all means all trigonometric ratios are positive. Silver means sin theta and cosecant theta are positive, remaining are negative. T means tan theta and cot theta are positive. And cups means cos theta and secant theta are positive. Now, in this quadrant 1, the values 0 degree is less than theta is less than 90 degree. Now, here we should take 90 minus theta and 360 plus theta. Then you come to the second quadrant. So, here 90 degree is less than theta is less than 180 degree. So, in this quadrant, 90 plus theta and 180 minus theta are there. In third quadrant, T means tan theta and cot theta are positive, remaining are negative. Here, the theta value lies between 180 degree to 270 degree. So, next, you come to the quadrant 4. So, in quadrant 4, 270 theta plus 360 minus theta are there. Cups means here cos theta and secant theta are positive, remaining are negative. Now, if theta lies in quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3 and quadrant 4, then the sine of trigonometric ratios as follows. Now, 90 degree and 270 degree are odd right angles. Then we get co-ratio. Co-ratio means sin theta will becomes to cos theta will becomes to sin theta, tan theta will becomes to cot theta and cot theta will becomes to tan theta, cosecant theta will becomes to secant theta will becomes to cosecant theta. Now 180 degree and 360 degree are even right angles. Then we get the same ratio. Same ratio means what children? Sin theta will becomes to sin theta. And cos theta will becomes to cos theta. Tan theta will becomes to tan theta. Like that. Now let us one by one you find the in quadrant 1 all 6 trigonometric ratios. In quadrant 1 sin 90 minus theta is there. So, 90 minus theta means sin 90 minus theta equal to cos theta. And why? Because 90 and 270 are odd right angles. That's why we get the co-ratio. Sin theta will becomes to cos theta. And cos theta will becomes to sin theta. So, that's why cos 90 minus theta equal to sin theta. Tan 90 minus theta equal to cot theta, cot 90 minus theta equal to tan theta. So similarly, in quadrant 1, 360 plus theta and 90 minus theta are there. That's why easy to find sin of 360 plus theta equal to sin theta. Means 360 degrees are even right angles. That's why we get same ratio. So